And so we must first understand the beliefs we already have about life. Then we must work to silence them, to heal them. And we've done this by connecting to our higher selves, to our source consciousness, to the energies of bliss and love and peace, to those divine qualities within our own being. That state of love, that state of purity and energy, naturally begins to clean away all of the karma. Why? Because every action that a human being seeks, that a human being creates, is in the pursuit of happiness. Look at our lives. Everything we do is an attempt to gain more happiness. Even our attempts to remove suffering are an attempt to gain more happiness. And so all of the desires we've ever had are to create happiness, either in ourselves or in others. When we connect deep within our hearts to that spiritual center within, that spiritual source of love and light within, we find happiness. We find the energy of happiness within ourselves, existing naturally, spontaneously. We do not have to work with our physical body's actions. We do not have to work with thoughts in our mind. We can find this happiness within ourselves at all times, wherever we are, within any situation. As we feel that happiness and allow it to increase, it naturally removes those karmic conditions. It removes those desires. Because within the experience of knowing this divine love, we gain new knowledge. We understand that what we were creating was the pursuit of happiness from outside ourselves, and that all the types of happiness we've ever found outside ourselves are not nearly as powerful, as loving, as nurturing, as this divine love that exists within us. What we also find is that this divine love that exists within us truly exists everywhere throughout space and time. It exists within every person. It exists within the air that we breathe. Because this divine love is the energy field underlying all of manifest creation. Often in the past, we have made attempts to try to find this happiness outside of us. And we found temporary, limited forms of happiness. We found happiness that's the result of changing the hormones or the brain chemicals within our body. And so there is the happiness that comes with adrenaline or with serotonin or with dopamine. There is the happiness that comes with sexual activity. We have also found limited and temporary forms of happiness in our emotional dimension. When we relate to other people, we feel emotional joy. We feel peace. We feel comfort. These are energies in another layer of ourselves. But they again are temporary. They come into creation based upon cause and effect. We must create something to have the resulting emotional energetic experience. And then there is also a happiness in the mental body. That is the experience of joy, of accomplishment. It is that feeling of reward when we gain new knowledge. It is the feeling of confidence. But beyond all of these temporary energies based upon cause and effect is that timeless, uncreated, constant flow of divine love energy within your spiritual heart. And it's always present. And we feel this love just because we place our awareness upon it, just because we've learned how to go deepest within and connect to our soul, connect to God. And we've opened ourselves to allow some of that divine energy to come into our being. The more effectively we can open our hearts and allow that divine love in through our bodies, mind, and emotions, the more fully we carry it here in every moment. And what we realize is that this divine love is not contingent upon anything happening around us in our lives. The love is not controlled by the words of another person. It is not controlled by the actions of another person. It is not controlled by what happens in the natural world in any way. In fact, when this divine love becomes full enough, it fills our emotions, and even our human relationships can never take away that divine love. Our human relationships can add new emotions within that divine love. It is like adding new flavors to a dish of food. The love is always there, it is ever present, because it has not been conditioned by this world. It was not found in the cause and effect relationships of the external world. The divine love was found within us. And it is realized, when that experience becomes full enough, that this divine love is truly a dimension of creative energy underlying all of life. It is the foundation from which the universe is built upon. And so, in this third video, we are going to briefly return to that deepest part of ourselves, the place of consciousness. We're going to find our peace. And then we're going to re-engage with the emotional body, feeling our chakras. Then we are going to tune into our spiritual hearts and allow that energy to come into every chakra, every part of ourselves. By bringing divine love into all parts of ourselves, we create true healing. Because everything that we desired from this world no longer needs to be sought after. The happiness we tried to find out here in this world has now been found within our hearts. And so the search is over. We found God within ourselves. And as we stay in this place, we realize that God has always been everywhere, within every person. When that awareness happens, when that realization happens, then we are able to bring that love into everything we do. And then any other emotions that we have simply add to that experience. Even sadness is an emotion experienced in joy, in bliss, and in love. Because the sadness is a natural part of the human process. This is important to understand. All the emotions that we experience are based upon cause and effect relationships within this world. They are not bad nor wrong. Please do not create a fight within yourself against your emotions or against your mind, or even against anyone else in this world. When we realize that our spirit is the source of divine love, we transcend our struggles. We transcend the control that the emotions have over us. And blissful love becomes ever-present. And emotions will still be felt, but they will not control you. And the more you stay in this divine blissful love, the more powerful the bliss becomes, and the less internal the emotions become within you. It is like you're finding a new center from which to create yourself, and that is the center of blissful divine love.